our help is in the name of the Lord. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Good morning. Today we celebrate the third Sunday in Lent, and so let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so by following your holy will we may gain eternal salvation.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let's say together the first form of the Confiteor found on page 66 as it is Lent. Almighty Father, you know my deepest secrets. I confess that I have, through my own fault, sinned against your holy laws. In my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done or failed to do, I sincerely regret my sins, and I am truly sorry for offending you. I ask, Father, that in your mercy you pardon my sins. I promise to change my way of living so that through a deeper holiness I may better serve the rest of my life. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say to our fathers, may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. Therefore, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength.
The Lord your God shall be feared. Him shall you serve, and all his name shall be.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and it shall be, world without end. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, help us to love your commandments and to follow your precepts, so that we may extend your kingdom on earth and do your will as it is done in heaven. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our first reading.
The first reading, a reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, God delivered all these commandments. I, the Lord, am your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery. You shall not have other gods besides me. You shall not carve idols for yourselves. In the shape of anything in the sky above or on the earth below or in the waters beneath the earth. You shall not bow down before them or worship them. For I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, inflicting punishment for their father's wickedness on the children of those who hate me, down to the third and fourth generation, but bestowing mercy down to the thousandth generation, on the children of those who love me and keep my commandments. You shall not take the name of the Lord and God, your God, in vain, for the Lord will not leave unpunished the one who takes his name in vain. Remember to keep the holy, the Sabbath day. 6 days you may labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord, your God. No work may be done by either of you or your son or daughter, or your male or female slave, or your beast, or by the alien who lives with you. In 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea and all that is in them, but on the seventh day he rested. That is why the Lord has blessed the Sabbath day and made it holy. Honor your father and mother, that you may have a long life in the land, which the Lord, your God, is giving to you. You should not kill. You should not commit adultery. You should not steal. You should not bear false witness against your neighbor. You should not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife. Nor this male or female slave, nor his ox or ass, nor anything else that belongs to him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond, Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the simple.
Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye.
Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinance of the Lord are true, all of them just.
Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
There are more precious than gold than a heap of the purest gold, sweeter also than syrup or honey from the comb.
Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
The second reading is a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Jews demand signs and Greeks look for wisdom, but we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles. But to those who are called, Jews and Greeks alike, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For the foolishness of God is wiser than the human wisdom, and the weakness of God is stronger than human strength. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might have eternal life. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Since the Passover of the Jews was near, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. He found in the temple area those who sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as the money changers seated there. He made a whip out of cords and drove them all out of the temple area with the sheep and oxen and spilled the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And to those who sold the doves, he said, "Take these out of here and stop making my father's house a marketplace." His disciples recalled the words of Scripture, "Zeal for your house will consume me." At this, the Jews answered and said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you will raise it up in 3 days?" But he was speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they came to believe the scripture and the word Jesus had spoken. While he was in Jerusalem for the feast of Passover, many began to believe in his name when they saw the signs that he was doing. But Jesus would not trust himself to them because he knew them all and did not need anyone to testify about human nature. He himself understood it well. This is the gospel of the Lord. Zeal for your house will consume me. Those are taken from today's gospel according to St. John, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, a lot of times people have come to me with questions about why Jesus acted so much out of the character that we seem to have in our minds about him when he overturned the tables in the temple and drove out all of the animals and the people. Need to remember that the temple in Jerusalem was the place where the presence of God was. It was built to house the Ten Commandments. The tablets, the Ten Commandments, were actually written upon by God himself. And in the Holy of Holies, which was in the backmost section of the temple, is where it was, and only the priests could go in there. But just outside of that was also supposed to be sacred space. And this is where it was the money changers and the animals had infiltrated into a very holy area. And this was done by the acts of the leaders of the temple, the scribes and the Pharisees, because what they did was rent out space in the holy place of the temple to try to enrich themselves. Because the temple itself was supported on a separate basis. So this was really about sin entering in to the holy space where God was living. That's why Jesus was so very, very upset. Because evil had infiltrated the holy. And that is something we've needed to guard about from that time all the way to our present day. We need to be very careful about what we let in. And talking about on the institutional level of the church, the bishops and the priests are generally very careful about that, but also into our own parishes and even into our own hearts. Because as holy as it was having the tablets of the Ten Commandments in the temple, how much more holy is it when we have the actual body, blood, soul, and divinity of our Lord in each church? So we need to be on guard about keeping things holy. But the same, again, is true of ourselves, that we are temples of the Holy Spirit. When we receive the body and blood of Christ, we become a temple. And so when sin comes in, it's kind of the same thing. We need to do what we can to exorcise that out with confession, with reconciliation, with receiving absolution. So as we go through this Lent, perhaps we can take some time and look at ourselves and how we have perhaps let our own temple be profaned. And what can we do to get that out of our lives so that we can become a proper vessel, as proper as we can in our humanity, for the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Christ, and receive him worthily and hopefully inherit the heavenly kingdom with him at the end of our time on earth. Zeal for your house will consume me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us all as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with his Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Trusting that God hears and answers our prayers, we now approach him with all of our needs. Our response will be, Lord, have mercy.
For the church, that the season of Lent may continue to be a time of interior renewal and purification through faith and sacraments, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For world leaders, that God will direct their steps into ways of peace, justice, and respect for all human life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the services and ministries supported by our contributions to the mission collection, that their works may be fruitful as they continue to serve our communities in need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick, especially those on the parish prayer list, that they may find consolation through Christ's healing presence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, and for whom this Mass is offered, for the repose of the souls of Winona Vallejo and Christopher Swearingen, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the souls of all the faithful departed, and those who will die today, that they may rest in eternal peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, you are the giver and preserver of all good things. Help us to keep and honor your commandments. Give us grace and strength to follow you more closely. As all these things, spoken and unspoken, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Owe nothing to anyone except love for one another, for the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your service. Bread to offer, proof is given, human hands have made. May it become for us the bread of life. For the mystery of this wine, and water, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, through your goodness, we have wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, may it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless this sacrifice to be prepared for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the Passion, Resurrection, and Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. May they, whose memory we honor on earth, intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Almighty God, may these oblations purify us from our sins, that we may be found an acceptable people in your sight. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through our fasting, you increase divine life within us. You preserve us from sin and lead us into eternal life. Through our abstinence, you confirm us in goodness and curb our unbridled vices. As we commemorate this 40-day fast of your Son, may we, together with him, give you glory. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna.
Holy Sacrifice of the Mass will continue with Eucharistic Prayer 3, which is found on page 84. We acclaim you, Holy Lord, glorious in power. Your mighty works reveal your wisdom and love. You have formed us in your own image, giving the whole world into our care, so that, in obedience to you, our Creator, we might rule and serve all your creatures. When our disobedience took us far from you, you did not abandon us to the power of death. In your mercy, you came to our help, so that in seeking you, we might find you. Again and again, you called us into covenant with you, and through the prophets, you taught us to hope for salvation. Gracious God, you loved the world so much that in the fullness of time you sent your only Son to be our Savior. Incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, he lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, the prisoners freedom, to the sorrowful joy. To fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world and to bring to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified, having loved his own who are in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which is given for you." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." We now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, recalling Christ's death and descent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and ascension to your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering to you from the gifts you have given us, this bread and this cup, we praise you and bless you. Together, we praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God. We pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for your holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that all who share this bread and this cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your name. Remember your one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. Remember Anthony, our prime bishop, Charles, our administrator, and all who minister in your church. Remember all your people and those who seek your truth, especially those of our friends and family. Remember all who have died in the peace of Christ, whose faith is known to you alone, especially Winona and Christopher, for whom we offer this Mass. Bring them into the place of eternal joy and light, and grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with our ancestors in faith, with the prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and all the saints who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them and give you glory through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Creator of all, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen. On page 95, let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ?
Yes, there is one bread. We who are many are one body, but we all partake of one.
May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace. My peace I give you." Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. us say together the first communion prayer found on page 97. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching and never let me be parted from you. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. For those who are joining us online or who for personal reasons cannot receive the body and blood of Christ today, please join me now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love. My Lord and Savior. Amen. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord. The body and blood of Christ. 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 Body and blood of Christ. Amen. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Amen. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ.
Who builds a boat with no clouds in sight? Who walks up to a giant and picks a fight? Who turns a lion's den into a petting zoo? Who can have church in a fiery furnace? Well, I'll tell you who. Crazy people trust in Jesus, following him wherever he leads us. Kingdom seekers, walk by faith believers. Here's the church, here's the steeple, here's the all God's crazy. Public school, who shares a gospel even when the world calls them a fool, and who's not afraid to go. 'cause I'm one of those crazy people, trusting Jesus, following him wherever he leads us. Kingdom seekers, walk by faith believers. Here's the church, here's the steeple, here's the all God's crazy. Talks to Jesus like he's real.
Crazy.
Who believes the words in red?
Crazy.
Who says he's coming back again?
Crazy.
Crazy people trust in Jesus, following him wherever he leads us. Kingdom seekers, walk by faith believers. Here's the church, here's the steeple.
See that you do not reject the one who speaks, for if they did not escape when they refused the one who warned them on earth, how much more in our case if we turn away from the one who warns us from heaven?
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you have given us this holy season for repentance and atonement. May we, through the grace of this Eucharist, always respond to your voice. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. As promised, today we have the swearing in. But first I would like to read the letter from Father Senior Charles Zawistowski. Dear Father John, thank you for your letter of February 5th, 2024, with the results of your election meeting and conveying your acceptance. I hereby approve and confirm those elected to the parish committee and other positions on February 4th, 2024 for Holy Trinity Parish, Kewanee, Illinois. Thank you also for including your pastor's report, parish financial report, and list of members with contact information. I extend my congratulations and best wishes to those who have been elected and am grateful that they are willing to serve the parish and fulfill the obligations of their respective offices and positions for the welfare of the parish and the good of our diocese and national church. May Almighty God bless Father John, those elected, and the faithful of Holy Trinity Parish as you continue to serve God and his people in your community. Sincerely in Christ, Very Reverend Charles Zawistowski, Administrator of the Western Diocese PNCC. With that, I now call forward Chairperson Bert Erdman, Vice Chairperson Mike Van Hefty, Recording Secretary Nancy Ball, Financial Secretary Kathy Erdman, Building Chair Mike Kubinski Sr., Treasurer Laura Kubiak, Directors Agnes Kramer, Carol Entis, and Richard Kubiak. We are gathered here today as a parish family to witness before Almighty God the installation of the parish committee and other elected officers. The duties and responsibilities of the parish committee should be carried out with devotion, dignity, prayer, and attention to detail.
From the office of the parish, I present to you, Reverend Father Mike Kubinski, Nancy Ball, Carol Entis, Dan Kramer, Laura Kubiak, Rich Kubiak, myself, and Kathy Elton, to receive the oath of office and blessing in the name of the Holy Church so that we may fulfill our duties and responsibilities as outlined in the Constitution and laws of the Polish National Church, Catholic Church.
Brothers and sisters, we are all baptized into the one body of Christ and given gifts for a variety of ministries for the common good. Our purpose is to install these people in the name of God and of Holy Trinity Parish to the parish committee, a special ministry within the parish to which they were called and elected by the faithful of this parish. You have been called to serve on the parish committee of Holy Trinity Parish. Will you faithfully and reverently execute the duties of your office to the honor of God and to the benefit of the members of the congregation? And if you do, so say, I will. God provides the church with suitable men and women to assist the pastor and be leaders of this congregation. Let us pray for these men and women that the God may bless them as they undertake their roles of service to this parish. Let us pray. God of glory, your beloved Son has shown us that true worship comes from humble and contrite hearts. Bless our brothers and sisters who have responded to the needs of our parish and seek to commit themselves to your service as members of this parish committee. Grant that through their ministry, they may set an example of dedicated, faithful service pleasing in your sight. We ask this through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And now for the oath, I would ask you to repeat after me. I state your name and office. Do solemnly swear before Almighty God and this congregation that I will live the gospel of Christ. Support the Constitution of the Polish National Catholic Church. And bear true faith and allegiance to the same. Under the authority of the bishop or his designate of this diocese, I will justly, honestly, faithfully, impartially, and conscientiously perform all the duties of my office according to the best of my ability. So help me God, one in the Blessed Trinity and all the saints. Amen. In the name of God and under the authority of Very Reverend Senior Charles Zawistowski and his pastor of Holy Trinity Parish, I install you as the parish committee for the year of our Lord 2024. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Holy Trinity Parish, your 2024 parish committee. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace. The sacrifice is offered. Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us for our Holy Mass today. We pray that you have a wonderful rest of your day, rest of your weekend. Stay safe, take care of yourselves, take care of each other, remain in a state of grace. By evil or if you find it, spread joy wherever you go.